Hello children, how are you? How do you feel learning through your online classes? Okay, anyway we have no other option. So let us continue chapter number 2, linear equations in one variable, exercise 2.2. Question number 14. Lakshmi is a cashier in a bank. She has currency notes of denominations of rupees 100, rupees 50 and rupees 10 respectively. The ratio of these notes is 2:3:5. The total cash with Lakshmi is rupees 4 lakh. How many notes of each denomination does she have? Children, from this question we can see we have to find the number of notes of each denomination. So, Lakshmi has here rupees 100 notes, 50 rupee notes and 10 rupee notes. Also, ratio is given as 2:3:5. Ratio is a comparison. It means if Lakshmi has 2 notes of rupees 100, she has 3 notes of rupees 50 and 5 notes of rupees 10. Which number is less in number? Here, from this we can see 100 rupee notes is less in number. So we have to take that number as Y. Solution. Let the number of rupees 100 notes be 2y. Here we have taken instead of y as 2y because here we have the ratio 2:3:5 and the number connected with 100 rupee notes is 2. So the number of rupees 50 notes is 3y. The number of rupees 10 notes is 5y. Amount we have from 100 rupee notes is equal to, we have to multiply the number of notes into its a denomination. So 2y into 100 is equal to 200y. Amount we have from rupees 50 notes is equal to 3y into 50 is equal to 150y. Amount we have from rupees 10 notes is equal to 5y into 10 is equal to 50y. Total amount Lakshmi has, we have to add the three numbers, 200y plus 150y plus 50y. In question it is also given as 4 lakh. So we can compare and write the equation as 200y plus 150y plus 50y is equal to 4 lakh. Adding these three terms we get 400y. So equation becomes 400y is equal to 4 lakh. Therefore y is equal to 4 lakh divided by 400 is equal to 1000. So number of 100 rupee notes is equal to 2y and it is equal to 2 into 1000 equal to 2000. The number of 50 rupee notes is equal to 3y is equal to 3 into 1000 is equal to 3000. The number of 10 rupee notes is equal to 5y is equal to 5 into 1000 is equal to 5000. Question number 15. I have a total of rupees 300 in coins of denomination rupees 1, rupees 2 and rupees 5. The number of rupees 2 coins is 3 times the number of rupees 5 coins. The total number of coins is 160. How many coins of each denomination are with me? So children, after reading question, we have to think what is to be found out. Here we have to find the number of coins of denomination. Denomination means value of a coin. And you can see here the denomination is 5, denomination is 2 and denomination is 1. So we have to find out the number of coins of each denomination. So which variable we have to take as Y? Here, which coin we have less in number, that we have to take as y. Here, for this, read the line. The number of rupees 2 coins is 3 times the number of rupees 5 coins. It means, if we have 1 5 rupee coin, then we have 3 2 rupee coins. It means, we have less coins of 5 rupee coins. Okay, so let us think of the steps. Solution. Let y be the number of 5 rupee coin. So the number of 2 rupee coins is 3 times. So 3 into y, 3y. Total number of coins is given as 160. So the number of 1 rupee coin, how can we find out? We have to subtract 5 rupee coins and 2 rupee coins from the total number. So it becomes 160 minus y minus 3y. And you know children, minus y and minus 3y, adding time we get minus 4y. So number of 1 rupee coin is 160 minus 4y. Now we have to calculate the amount which we get from the coins. amount I got from 5 rupee coins is equal to 5 into y is equal to 5y. How can we find this out? Here you have got the hint. Amount is equal to number of coins into denomination. And amount I got from 2 rupee coins is equal to number of coins is 3y. So 3y into 2 is equal to 6y. Amount I got from 1 rupee coins equal to number of coins 160 minus 4y into its denomination 1 is equal to 160 minus 4y. Total amount I have, we have to add all these numbers, all these. So 5y plus 6y plus 160 minus 4y. This amount is given as rupees 300. By data, we can make the equation 5y plus 6y plus 160 minus 4y is equal to 300. Now you have to remove the bracket. So the equation becomes 5y plus 6y plus 160 minus 4y is equal to 300. And we have to add these like terms, first two terms, 11y minus 4y plus 160 is equal to 300. Here if you want, you can add all the like terms 5y, 6y and minus 4y. But here we have done in two steps. 11y minus 4y plus 160 equal to 300. Now 11y minus 4y is 7y. 7y plus 160 is equal to 300. And plus 160 we have to transpose. So it becomes minus 160. So the equation becomes 7y is equal to 300 minus 160. Subtracting time we get 140. So 7y is equal to 140. Therefore y is equal to 140 divided by 7. And we get 20. So y means the number of 5 rupee coins. So number of 5 rupee coins is 20. So number of 2 rupee coins equal to 3y means 3 into 20 is equal to 60. So the number of 1 rupee coins is equal to 160 minus 4y is equal to 160 minus 4 into y value is 20. So 160 minus 80 is equal to 8. Question number 16. The organizers of an essay competition decide that a winner in the competition gets a prize of rupees 100 and a participant who does not win gets a prize of rupees 25. The total prize money distributed is rupees 3000. Find the number of winners if the total participants is 63. Children, after reading the question, we know that we have to find the number of winners. So we have to take it as y. Now what else is given? A winner gets a prize of rupees 100 and a participant gets a prize of rupees 25. The total number of participants is given as 63. Now let us think of the solution. Here let the number of winners be y. Total number of participants is equal to 63. So the number of participants who did not win is equal to 63 minus y. Now the amount bought by a winner is given as rupees 100. So the amount bought by y winners is equal to y into rupees 100. The amount bought by a participant who did not win is given as rupees 25. So the amount got by 63 minus y participants is equal to 63 minus y multiplied by rupees 100. Now these two amounts, when you add, we get a rupees 3000. So by the given information, we can write as 100y plus 25 into 63 minus y is equal to 3000. And we have to solve the bracket first. We have to multiply 25 with 63 and 25 with minus y. So it becomes 100y plus 1575 minus 25y is equal to 3000. Now see the equation. We have like terms 100y and minus 25y. So solve them. So we get 75y. The equation becomes 75y plus 1575 is equal to 3000. Now plus 1575 we have to take to the other side, it becomes minus. So the equation becomes 75y is equal to 3000 minus 1575, and subtracting time we get 1425. So we get 75y is equal to 1425. So y is equal to 1425 divided by 75, and dividing time we get 19. So the number of winners is 19.